हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर फोर्थ चैप्टर दैट इज़ कम्युनिकेशन, ई कॉमर्स एंड आउटसोर्सिंग. राइट, कम्युनिकेशन दैट वी ऑल आर फैमिलियर विद द टर्म, राइट, दैट यू नो दैट टॉकिंग विद अ पर्सन, दैट एक्सचेंज ऑफ थॉट्स एंड फीलिंग्स. राइट, नाउ डेज दैट कम्युनिकेशन दैट हैज बीन बिकम फास्टर विद द हेल्प ऑफ इंटरनेट. राइट, यू गाइज आर यूजिंग दैट सोशल मीडिया, फेसबुक, व्हाट्सएप, राइट, और कॉलिंग योर फ्रेंड्स, कॉलिंग अप योर फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम योर सेल फोन. ओके, राइट, देन ई कॉमर्स दैट the various, you know, that online selling platforms like Flipkart, Amazon, right, these are considered under the e-commerce, that is electronic commerce, right, that many of us that we are using this facility or services that has been provided by Flipkart and Amazon, right, online selling platform. Outsourcing, that means it is the one kind of, you know, that we can say that call centers that are available in our country, right, that doing up a back office work and a back office job, right, everything we are going to get into detail, right. Okay, starting with the first, that is communication. I have only covered the small topic, that is meaning and definition, right? And understand this thing, that this chapter is not covered in your 50 marks examination that is going to be conducted from the next week. Okay, right, we have only three chapters. Okay, right, communication, the meaning, see, it is a made of two Latin words, that is communis and communicare, right, that means to share a common thing, right, like if I want to convey something, if I want to convey a message, right, then it will be a common thing, right, that yes, that the two person, they are doing a communication with any kind of a purpose, with any kind of objective, right, right. But slowly and gradually the meaning of communication that has been changed over the years, right, getting my point. See, during the primitive era, right, people there, you know, that they don't know how to speak, right, so they were communicating in that signs, in a language, in a sign language, right, they're only using their hands at various signs that they are making, right. But then the particular when we learn to speak, we have we know that we are exchanging thoughts and expressions and feelings of each other, right, and whatever the things that we are doing right now, right, I'm communicating with you guys. Okay, right, so it's a communication, it is a two-way process, right, it is the process that, you know, that sending information from a source to a target, right, that like I'm a particular source, that I'm sending you a particular, you know, that I'm communicating with you with the online platform, right, that a video that I'm putting onto it, and you guys are the target, right. Ultimately what I'm going to do, that as a sender, I'm going to collect the information in the proper form, right, and this is important, that sending it via a medium or a channel, right, that a proper medium of communication or a proper channel of communication that need to be selected, so that the receiver of the information, the receiver of the particular data, must interpret into the right way and they can get the better idea, they can understand the message. Okay, right, so as I said, right, in the receiver, this is what he's going to do, he's going to interpret the message, right, and they are going to respond. Okay, like, you know, if you are talking with our friends, with our relatives, or with anyone, what we are going to do as a sender, I'm going to send a message, and the receiver at the other end, he's going or she is going to understand the message, and at least they are going to respond. Reply must be there. Then and then only we can say that yes, the message that we are going to, or we are about to send, that has been understood by the receiver very well. Right? So what we can say, that in communication, that information, concept, emotions, feelings, or instructions are being exchanged between two or more person, right? Two or more person. It is not only about that, you know, it is not limited up to the two persons only. I'm sending the message, I'm sending this video, I'm putting up the video, right? And you as a student are watching it, and you guys are in more in numbers. Getting my point, right? So this communication, it is what? It is a two-way process, right? That a sender and a receiver both need to be interpreted the message correctly. If they are not understanding the message correctly, then communication is going to fail. Now, how this communication is going to be helpful in the business, right? Because see, if I want to give order to someone, if I want to purchase something, right, communication must be there. I will be calling up the particular person and telling, yes, I need this and this much of a goods or a commodity into the particular area or a particular region or in a specific quantity, right? So communication is necessary, right? Due to communication, that the, you know, that we are involving into the import and export business through the communication, right? We can give order, international orders, right? Like, you know, that nearly that, you know, that on the 3rd of August, we are having the festival of Raksha Bandhan. Right, many of the, you know, that that sister and brothers, they are, you know, they are living in a different country, but still they are sending the sisters, they are sending Rakhi to their brothers, right? How it can be possible? Through communication, through with the help of internet facility, right? Getting my point? Okay. And there are two types of communication are there, right? That is verbal communication and non-verbal communication. What is verbal communication? That is, I have underlined or highlighted a particular thing, that when a message are transmitted through words, that is through a language, that whatever that you know that we are doing right now, that I'm, you know, that I'm speaking, you guys are understanding that thing, that is a verbal communication, right? That information, either it can be in written or it can be in the oral form, right? That, see, it is a particular thing, that yes, it is a written thing, that is also there, and I'm speaking also, that is the oral thing, right? You guys are speaking with your friends, you guys are talking with your friends and relatives, and that is the word, that is a verbal communication that you guys are doing, right? But for that, what is the main thing? That is proper selection of words and their placement and of the formation of the sentence, that is also going to be play a very important role into the verbal communication, right? See, because everything, every word, that it has two meanings, every sentence, it can be, become a two meanings, that a proper punctuation, that is also going to be needed, right? If the sender, that means the speaker, is not able to convey the message in a proper way or in a proper form, then the receivers, that audience, they're not going to understand the message. They are going to interpret the message wrongly, and it is going to be what? It is going to be a failure for whom? It is going to be a failure for the sender. That is the particular, whoever is the sending the message. Right? Getting my point? And short and simple language or short and simple sentence, that will be there, right? So that audience are not going to get bored and they can understand the message easily, right? Short and easy to understand. Other thing is non-verbal communication. Now, what is non-verbal communication? That, you know, that without using a word, that is a written communication, right? I'm just, you know, that just writing something or sending it to the particular, like I'm a particular, you know, that having a production head, right? I'm handling the particular production department, and I want to send a message to the other departmental heads or a particular, you know, that to my fellow workers, I will be sending them the mail, right? That is the written communication. No oral or no words that has been spoken up, right? So that, you know, that information is exchanged through signals, physical expression, gestures, postures, facial and eye expression in artistic way, that looks like music, singing, dance, sculpture, pictures, drawing, maps, cannon, salute, siren, etc. Right? Getting my point? So it is like that, like, you know, that, you know, some expressions that has been given, right? Signals that has been given, signals, you guys are, you know, that very familiar with that, right? In examination, you are going to do that particular, you know, exchange of signals will always be there. Okay, physical expression, like, you know, if you're angry with someone, you can give that expression. You can, with eye expression, you can know about the things, yes, that person is angry with you, right? Is trying to say something through pictures, through drawings, through maps, everything that we can do. That is what, that is a non-verbal communication. Okay, getting my point, right? Then the specific definition of the communication, right? It has been two. See, if it is been asked in 1 mark, then you can write the first definition, that is, communication means exchange of thoughts, opinions and information through speech, writing or signs, right? That is called as what? That is called as a communication. But if it is asking 2 mark, then you need to write down the second one. Remember this thing, right? That is, it is a process of exchange of information among people, exchange of information among the people regarding knowledge, concept, understanding, emotions, feelings and opinions, that whatever things that we are doing right now, that we are exchanging the information, right? About what? About the knowledge, about the concept of the subject, right? Getting my point? Second part, the sender selects proper medium which affects the receiver, right? That we have selected this e-learning, right? Through YouTube channel, I'm going to put up the video, you are going to see the video, right? That can make more impressive or that more, you know, that understandable about the concept. Getting my point, right? And as a result, his or her behavior is changed, that your behavior, that as a receiver, your behavior is going to be changed, right? And a relationship with him or her established and maintained, that is me as a teacher, you guys as a student, we have that, you know, that relationship that we have established, and that relationship will be maintained. Getting my point, right? So it is a simple thing, that, you know, that the what we are doing, it is a two-way process, as we have already seen in the concept or the meaning, that is, that thoughts, emotions, knowledge, that opinions that are going to be exchanged, right? As a sender, I will be selecting a proper way of communication, that I will be selecting this guy, that, you know, that PPT, that video with includes the video of mine, right? And you guys are what? You guys are listening to it, you guys are understanding the concept, you guys are understanding that particular, that whatever the knowledge that you, that I'm imparting into you, right? Getting my point? So that is called as what? That is called as a communication. Understand this thing, that yes, definition, If it is in asking 1 mark, you need to write down the first one. If it is asking 2 mark, the other one, that is the second one, right? In the next lecture, we are going to continue with the process of communication, right? Okay, just go through the first, second and third chapter, understand this thing, right? Go to the first and second, third chapter. If you want the notes of PDF, let me know, send me the message so I can forward it to you, right? Go through the video, start revising. If you have any doubt, do let me know in the first 3 chapters as well as in this lecture or in this video. Okay, right? Thank you.